Hello and welcome to my first YouTube video! Special thanks for Abe for making the intro. If you like to see more, don't forget to like and subscribe. In this video I'll be explaining how to do the GTA Perico heist solo hard mode with the challenge. Before I start explaining, there are three versions of this video or the heist, so make sure to watch the whole content. Before I start explaining the three versions of the heist, when you do the scouting on the island, make sure you go to the marked areas on the map and look for clothing and the grappling hook. To do this, there are three versions. Once with the vellum, once with the long fin, and the most rare one you can do is with the Kosatska submarine. No matter what heist you do, always make sure you take the suppressed weapons. If you do the heist with the vellum, always make sure to take the weapon stash. Otherwise you will start with instant aggro as soon as you land your vellum. When you arrive at the island, turn left, enter the hangar. Your weapons will be on the inside on the left hand side. After you picked up your weapons, it's time to fill up your bags. Normally you would get gold, but with your solo mode, so gold is not an option. Next best thing is cocaine. One pile of cocaine will give you 50% bag space. After that you can get weed, that's 40% of your bag, cash will be 25%, and painting will be 50%, but the painting has the same value as cash. Due to a recent update, you can now only enter the hangar once. Plan correctly how to fill up your bag. If you do enter the hangar for a second time, you end up with instant aggro. This means that the challenge is a fail because you cannot get aggro to complete the challenge. After you are done filling up your bag, it's time to go get your clothing and your grappling hook. Due to a lot of strange things happening in Perico Heist, I always take out these two guards and this security camera around the corner. In this run of the Perico Heist, the clothing is located on the balcony. It's best to always take out this guard. This guard is apparently equipped with X-ray and or heat vision because he can see you through concrete walls. After that, it is time to pick up the grappling hook. Now we're all done with the clothing and the grappling hook. It's time to go to the compound. I will fast forward this video until we get to the compound. Now that we have arrived at the compound, drive to the far end and turn left. Here is a location to use the grappling hook. Remember, a grappling hook can be used at the same location twice, as well for the entry as for the exit. Once you go over the wall, you only need to kill three guards, as you can see in a moment. Inside the compound, there are two options to get into the vault. One is by using the elevator in Mr. Rubio's office. Here you need to hack four fingerprint puzzles. Second is the tunnel. Here you need to hack only two fingerprint puzzles. Do note this route requires you to loot keys. Do not mistake them for key cards. Although I loot the keys in this video, in this heist with the vellum, I will show the normal route to Mr. Rubio's office. The route via the tunnel I will show in the explanation video of the heist entry with the Kosatska. No matter what you do in this heist, grouped or solo, always check the safe because it will not consume backspace. For this last bit, I will speed up this video. Once you get your primary target, it will be an easy way out. You just need to look out for one guard. Let him pass and you can run to the wall and jump over. To make it an easy exit, follow the shoreline and do not walk through plants as they will slow you down. Jump in the water and swim towards deeper water. Look at the minimap. If you look closely, you'll see a tip sticking out in the last water depth line. swim towards it, slightly go past it and just stop. Just wait for the game to respond and you will leave the island, and the heist is completed. The long fin. This approach you can use if you have not found any clothing. As I did most of the explaining for the Perico heist with the Vellum, I will now only explain the difference for the Perico heist with the Longfin approach. The Longfin has a parking issue. It likes to drift away. If this happens, you can spend a lot of time swimming after your Longfin. To prevent the drifting away, I park the Longfin left of the main dock. Here the Longfin will bounce between the coast and the sandbank. In this run, the grappling hook is next to the parking spot. If this is not the case for your run, it's not a problem. Just pick it up before you go fill up your bag. Now that we are on the island, it's time to fill up our bag. Depending on where you need to go to fill up your bag, always take out this security card and the CCTV camera at the power plant. Just out of precaution, before I take out the guards, I take out the second CCTV camera. If you need to go to the hangar, just take out this guard. If you need to go to the second location, then take out the guard on the balcony. Jump over the wall. Best is to do this on the hangar side of the wall because this is the lowest point and easiest to get over. This run, apart from one pile of cocaine, there's only cash. To save time, I will not pick up the cash and I will not go to the hangar for another pile of cash. I will later on in this run take a painting for Mr. Rubio's office. I will show this later on in this video. Now it's time to go to the compound. I will now fast forward until we get to the drainage tunnels. Once arrived at the drainage tunnels, just jump in the water. Do not forget to equip your rebreather. You can do without it if you're really fast. If not, you will lose health, and if you're too slow, you will simply die. Swim to the drainage gate, cut it open, and swim into the compound. Once inside, the only difference with the run with the Vellum is that you need to take out 3 more cards. Card 1 and 2 are at the pool. I found it best to take out the one on the right first, then the one on the left. Remember, aim for the heads. Card number 3 is the one we skip with the Vellum run. Due to time passed and their patrol route, you now must take him out. From this point on, everything is the same as I showed earlier in the Vellum run. The Kosatka submarine. The only time you will use this for hard mode with the challenge is when you have 2 paintings in Mr. Rubio's office. As the beginning is the same as the start at the compound with the long fin, I will skip ahead where things get different from the Vellum and the long fin run. As I promised earlier in this video, I will now show the quickest way to get to the primary target with the keys. When I kill this guard, you can see the keys drop, and you see the text notification as I pick them up above the minimap. Now get the 2 paintings and loot the safe. Before you go down, you have to snipe this guard. Doesn't matter if you do it before or after looting the vault and picking up the paintings. If you do not kill him, you might have an issue escaping the island without getting seen. Now it is time to do the quick entry and exit from the vault of the primary target. Run back down, take a left, jump down. As you land, take a right and use the keys to open the gate. Once you are in, you need to do the fingerprint cloning puzzle. As you can see, you not only need to do 2 fingerprints, but you had to do 4 at the elevator at Mr. Rubio's office. Once you get your primary target, it's time to leave the compound. Go back to the drainage tunnel. Take a right here and open the door. as we do not have a grappling hook, as you should have with the Vellum and a long fin, we must exit by going out the front door. Now that you are outside, the way off the island is the same as before mentioned in the Vellum run. I hope that these three ways for the prequel heist will help you do them easier and quicker in the future. Feel free to leave any comment about the prequel heist as it still keeps changing. Thanks for watching my video. If you like this video, don't forget to like and subscribe. You're also welcome to join in when I'm live streaming.